after four judges concurring, and the only woman judge on the panel, Justice Indu Malhotra, is the only one who gave a dissenting opinion. Some of the key points in the majority judgment, the concurring judgment, is that the Ayyappa sect is not recognized as a separate religious sect, and the focus of the justices seems to be on the fact that women have an equal right to practice religion. So actually, Article 25, which is what the board was arguing for under, which is what the board was citing as the reason why they could keep women between 10 and 50 out, is actually what is being cited by the justices to protect the rights of women to practice religion freely. Justices have said that biological characteristics do not gather muster under the Constitution. They have said that this current practice blinks at the rights of women and at the Constitution. And they have emphasized that women must be given an equal right to pray, an equal right to religion. And this particular practice actually violates the Constitution, which is what the majority judgment, the four judges together, are saying. This Justice Indu Malhotra, however, says that the personal opinions of judges is not what should be ruling something like this, that religious practice can be protected, and that this, that the petitioners are wrong, and that this practice does not violate Article 17. Of course, Justice Indu Malhotra's judgment is in the minority, so the majority now saying that women between the ages of 10 and 50 will be allowed to enter the Sabarimala temple for now. Of course, the board is saying that there will be a review petition, but we will see about that later. For now, when October 15th comes, if nothing else has happened, according to the Supreme Court of India, women should be allowed entry into the Sabarimala temple. All right.